this? Any of one? So we should try, no? If a guru has told that you should keep, or he has kept your God, Param Guru, Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupa Goswami, have they? We should try to. Sadvritti. Satovritti. Go. Very small. Don't be upset by this. I'm not criticizing.
Janasalakaya Chakshurun Militam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhyaye Vacha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Mahavadannaya Krishna prema pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratise Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Itadalaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Tavai Vasmi Tavai Vasmi Najivami Toyabina Iti Bhikkhaye Radhe Tangnayama Macharanantike Bhaktya Bihinaya Paradha Lakshay Shiptascha Kamadika Sarangamadhe Kripa Mayin Twang Saranam Prapanna Binde Numaste Charanarabhinda
First of all, my heart touching. Millions of dandavat in the lotus feet of my spiritual master. And same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Om Vishnu Parsi Smad Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. We are now discussing about Raya Ramananda Sambhad. First lok, briefly we have explained, briefly. Now, some examples I told yesterday to give. Why? How Radha is Pranay Mahima? And for this, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Raya Ramanand to come to Puri and they will all test all these things. In the last, he resigned from his post and he came. So, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, in Swarupa Karcha, Karcha are slokas, what they realized with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they used to write in their Karcha, in their own slokas. Raghunath Goswami has also karcha. How he was born and brought upon the guidance of Sarup Damodar. And what Sarup Damodar used to hear from Mahaprabhu. And he used to tell him. So he has also karcha.
both combined, or each Chaitanya Charitamrita. So Radhaya Pranay Mahima Kirdisha. Va anayaiv vas svadva jenadbhut madhurima kirdisho va madiya. Sokhanchasya madanubhavata kirdisho vetti lobha. Tadbhavad samajani sachi garbh sindhu harindu. Oh, you should explain the meaning.
Om Jnanatimirandasya Jnananjanashalakaya Chakshurunmilitam yena tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vancha Kalpataru Bhascha Kripa Sindhu Bhevaja Patitanam Pavane Bhyo Vaishnavi Bhyo Namo Namah. First of all, I'm offering my humble Dandavat Pranams, my Shraddha Pushpanjali to the lotus feet of my beloved Gurudev Nityalila Pravishta Om Vishnu Pad Asto Tarasata Shri Shrimad A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada. And secondly, my equal Dandavat Pranams and Shraddha Pushpanjali to the lotus feet of my beloved Siksha Gurudevs Nityalila Pravishta Om Vishnu Pad Shri Shila Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Goswami Maharaj and Om Vishnu Padasto Tarasata Shri Shila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj and to all of my Rupanuga Guru Varga, all the Vaishnavas and Vaishnavas.
Better you should be like that. Yes.
So Srila Gurudev has been expounding for the past 2 days on Sri Roy Ramananda Samvad, in which he has quoted the first verse of that chapter 8 of Madhya Lila, which actually encompasses the entire conceptions that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu placed within the heart of Roy Ramananda, and by which he himself was able to hear this conversation and gain new enlightenment within his heart. The beautiful examples being given yesterday of the cloud and the ocean, and the pearls within the shell of the oyster, and the Swati Nakshatra, the constellation. Very beautiful description Srila Gurudev has given. And now Srila Gurudev is referring to the Kadachas, the shloka of Srila Swarup Damodar Goswami, which is quoted by Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami in the beginning of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita to explain the confidential reasons why Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in this world. In the third and fourth chapters of Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Lila, Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami has explained both the external reasons for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance in this world and also his internal reasons or his primary reasons. And this shloka, which Srila Gurudev has quoted, which we will explain, this is telling the three most confidential reasons why Sri Krishna himself desired to appear in the womb of Mother Sachi and descend in this world in his beautiful golden form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So here it is described, Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kidrushovana Yaiva Svadyo Yenad Bhuta Madhurima Kidrusho Va Madhya Sokyam chasyam mad anubhavata kidrisham veti lobhat tad bhavadya samajani sachi garbha sindho harindu. So here Shri, the first line is telling Shri Radhaya Mahima Kidrisho Vana Yaiva. He wanted to understand Krishna because he is the Vishaya Tattva Bhagavan, which means he is the object of everyone's prem. He is the object. And from that position of the Vishay Tattva, from the position of the object, he is tasting everyone's prema. But when Krishna witnessed the transcendental features and symptoms which are shown by Srimati Radharani in her love for him, by which she tastes the highest level of Mahabhav Prem and the highest levels within Mahabhav. So Krishna himself became very curious to understand, because he noticed that Srimati Radharani, her love is unlimited, expanding in all directions. There is no limit whatsoever to her prema for me. What is the greatness of that prema, the mahima, the topmost limit of that prema? Krishna himself wanted to understand this. But actually it is not possible for him to understand from his own position of being Vishai Tattva Bhagavan. Therefore, he desired, this was his first desire, he desired to take the position of Srimati Radharani herself, and thus through taking her position, experiencing her own bhavs. In this way, he would be able to taste her prema. Secondly, what is the second? Swadyo yena adbhuta madhurima kidrusho va madhya. Then he wanted to understand, what is the madhurima, the sweetness, that she tastes through her transcendental love for him? Because Sri Krishna is the very Bhagavan Swayam and the Avatari. He is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead from whom all other incarnations and expansions emanate. And he is the topmost absolute truth. So within him, there is the topmost qualities compared to all other expansions of his own self. And specifically, Sri Krishna has four qualities which are not found in any other incarnation. Four madhurimas. These are sweetnesses. His venu madhuri. How Sri Krishna plays his beautiful venu, his flute, and attracts the hearts of all living beings throughout the entire creation. Even the inanimate objects are attracted by the sweetness of the sound of Krishna's flute. Venu madhuri, lila madhuri. He engages in his sweet pastimes, encompassing his ages of childhood, boyhood, youth, kishore, balya, pauganda. And in this way, Krishna manifests so many beautiful, sweet pastimes in Braja, and in no other incarnation and in no other dham does the Supreme Lord manifest such beautiful pastimes. Then, Rupa Madhuri. Krishna's transcendental, beautiful form with all of his characteristics and qualities, his beautiful lotus petal eyes, his transcendental body is the very embodiment of sweetness. And all of his associates have prema madhuri. They're completely surrounding Krishna with the topmost level of prema, and particularly coming into the level of madhurya prema, which the Braja Gopis taste and experience in their love for Krishna. So through these four sweetnesses, through these four madhurimas, these qualities of Krishna, he inundates the hearts of his Braj Bhaktas, and eternally they relish his transcendental qualities and his sweetness. But amongst them, none of them can relish and taste the sweetness of Krishna of that of compared to Srimati Radharani. And Srimati Radharani, she is the Ashray Tattva, the very shelter or the very abode of all prema. She is the very Swarup Shakti potency of Krishna. There is the Sri Krishna himself, who is the absolute truth, and Sri Krishna's Shakti. Together they comprise the one absolute truth. So Srimati Radhika is that Swarup Shakti, that Purna Shakti, completely embodied through the potency of Ladini. Very transcendental pleasure potency. Srimati Radhika tastes the transcendental prema of Krishna and sweetness of Krishna to the highest level beyond anyone else. And when Krishna notices this, then he becomes also very curious to understand how she is tasting my sweetness. He notices that all living beings are tasting his sweetness. But he himself is enamored by the fact that Srimati Radhika is tasting unlimitedly. And finally, Sokyam Chasyam Mad Anubhavata Kidrisham Veti Lobhat. What kind of happiness, what kind of unlimited joy and ecstasy Srimati Radhika experiences. When Krishna witnesses this, he sees that she is tasting millions of times greater joy than he himself in receiving her prema and all other devotees' prema. So Krishna becomes absolutely curious to know this. And in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami has described, Krishna's mind runs after this conception. How it will be possible for him to understand this? So therefore, desiring to taste these, to experience and to know these three transcendental characteristics of Srimati Radhika's prema, therefore, Sri Krishna himself accepted the mood, the bhav, tad bhavadya samajani sachi garba sindho harindu. He took her bhav, that means her transcendental golden kanti, her color, and that in comprises her complete moods, her complete desire to love Krishna is embodied within that beautiful golden color. And Srimati Radhika herself, joined together, combined together in one form, and completely covered every single limb of Shyam Sundar Krishna in his dark, beautiful color. And now he became Gaur Sundar, and now he became completely absorbed in the mood of Srimati Radhika. So in that way, Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in this world and manifested his pastimes for the benefit of all, but particularly to taste these three, because he is the Supreme Absolute Truth, he is Raso Vaisaha, he is the embodiment of rasa, there is nothing beyond his experience. So in order to taste this ras, he has appeared in this form. And now, by meeting Sri Ramananda Roy on the banks of Godavari, and also empowering him to distribute these transcendental conceptions, and because, as we have heard, Roy Ramananda is none other than the most intimate Sakhi of Srimati Radhika, Sri Vishakha Devi herself. So now she has come to give, to contribute her conceptions into this transcendental samvad, this conversation. And Roy Ramananda now gave this into the heart of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and by his tasting and hearing this through the medium of Siksha Guru, he was now able to deeply enter within the moods of Srimati Radharani. So that is a brief explanation of this shloka of Sri Swarup Damodar Goswami Pada.
But why this shloka has been quoted here? What is the need? Oh, something. Here, it has been quoted, this shloka, especially for to show that what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu realized three things inspired in the heart of Raya Ramananda, this very thing. And that is why he was able to repeat it to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for this. So without mercy, anyone cannot know all these things. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sprinkled his mercy unknowingly, not outwardly, but inwardly. This is the thing. In Brihad Bhagavatamrita too, everything his guru told to Gop Kumar, Swarup perhaps, he told, he knew all the thoughts, but could not realize. Janu Sarma, sent by Radhika. Then he kept his hands on his head. Everything you should realize. And then at once he realized, and he saw that I am going to Golok Vrindavan, and in the meantime he reached there and he saw Krishna. So very powerful sadhu sangha. But sadhu sangha, standards should be there. Now I have told that how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu crossed the river Godavari and he came to Godavari Ghat, next other Ghat, and he took bath on the Ghat, proper Ghat. And after taking bath, he left that Ghat, but nearer to Godavari water, he was sitting, he sat down, and then he did his Anhik. Anhik, you know, what Guru has given months, you repeat 10 times. You should always try to follow this. Our Raghunath Das Goswami has also told, Guru Goshte Goshta Leisu Sujane Bhusurgane Swamantre Sri Namni Gantadisari. So don't fail to meditate your mantra 3 times daily. But if you are Grihastha, so many things to do. So if you cannot do in evening, midday, you must do in morning. And from sannyasi, brahmachari, those who have left homes, they should do at 3 times. So you must do what Guru has given mantra daily with very respectfully and being one-pointed. At that time, no upset mind, no in hurry. Be calm and quiet and chant. Even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is doing. Why you should not do? Then it has been told that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself told that I am Mayavadi Sannyasi. And someone quoted this, that he was Mayavadi Sannyasi. Because he has taken sannyas from Mayavadi Advait Sannyasi Keshav Bharati. But this is not true. He took Harinam Diksha from Ishwar Puripad. He is his Gurudev. He is only sannyas guru. And even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that, you are going to give me this mantra. And he strictly gave his mantra. What mantra was that? Tattvam asi. What meaning? Tasya tvam asi. You are eternal servant of Krishna. This mantra was that. Yes, Keshav Bharati, he took sannyas in the line of Shankaracharya. Like Madhvacharya took sannyas in the line of, but they were not Mayavadi. Mayavadi means Nishvisheshvadi. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had cut all the arguments of Sarvam Bhattacharya. And he used to pay respect to his Gurudev, Ishwar Puripad. He went to Ishwar Puripad birthplace, took some dust from there. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has told, I am Mayavadi Sannyasi. Why? Trinadapi suni chena tarorapi sahi sunat for this. All Vaishnavas should be Trinadapi suni tarorapi sahi sunina. Amanina manadina kirtanya. Especially sannyasi. Also, all Vaishnavas should be like, give honor to others. Don't be very for others, what he is doing. Nonsense or what? Don't criticize. Don't be worried for that. Try to see how much I am developing. I am following Trinadapi Sunich Tarorapi Sahisuna Amanina Manadena Kritiyasa. We should also know Api Chetsu Duracharu Bhajate Mam Ananyabhat Sadhu. Don't be worried for that. Otherwise, your life will be spoiled. constitutional of our religion is bhakti. If a kantiki bhakti is there and something coming, we should try to abhor and form it, all these things. Don't bother. Well, always you should know, Kaal is very powerful. But even those who have taken shelter, Sharanagati, in the lotus feet of Krishna, they can walk on the head of this time also. Those who give Vighna, obstacles, he can. So we should try to be Sharanagat and of only one point and then going and helping others also. Now, Raramanand is telling that I am Shudra. Oh, I am Sai Shudra. Why? Oh, again, this thing. Trinadapi Suni Cheno. He was actually no Shudra. And Srila Prabhupada has told those who think that he was Shudra, then he is aparadhi. He will not have bhakti. Haridas Thakur was Mohammedan Muslim, if they are thinking. Oh, he was not Muslim. By constitutional religion, he was pure Shuddha Bhakta Mahabhagavat Namacharya, giving shelters to Patits. Even Rupa and Sanatana Goswami, they thought that we are Muslims. And they took shelter in the lotus feet of Haridas Thakur. You know. So he was not, Vaishnavas are not Mohammedan Muslims or anything. They are Jagat Guru. So what they are telling, we should think it that Baituna Dapi Sunis, they are telling. So actually not like. Then some dialogue was going on between Raramanand and Mahaprabhu. Raramanand was telling that if you have come to reform me, then you are Patit Pavan, Param Dayal. Being a sannyasi, you touched untouchable me, he told. And then he quoted, Mahant Sobhav E Tarite Pamor Nijakar Janahutabe Jan Angha. For this, Mahat Bichalanang Nirinang Grihinang Dinachi Tasam Nisse Shaya Bhagwan Nanatha Kalpati Kushi. What is the meaning? Once Krishna and Balram, they have taken birth. After 6 months or 1 year, Vasudev Prabhu in Mathura, in jail, he requested Gargacharya, please go in Vrindavan. There, the son of my son and the son of Nanda have taken birth there. And now appropriate time, and you should give, you should do Naam Sanskar. He went there. In disguise means no one knew. If anyone will knew that Vasudev Maharaj has sent, then consul at once take some serious steps. So as if he is not moving here and there, he went there. So Nand Baba is telling him, Mahat Vichalnam Ridam Krihinam Dina Chetasam Nisheshaya Bhagavan Nannatha Kalpati Khushi. Mahat Vichalana, Mahat, Who is Mahat? Who is Mahat? Or Sanatana Goswami is telling Mahatam Bhagavat Sevaika Nishtha. Bhagavat Sevaika Nishthanam are Mahat. Those who have desire to serve Krishna and serving, they are really Mahat. No other reason. So you are Mahat. You have no other business here. But by chance, you have come here. Why you have come? Oh, two things. Grihinam dina chetasam. Myself, Grihinam. I am always engaged in householder life. In my wife, for children, to look after my homes and all these things. Who is telling?
Nanda Baba.
How this is? His son is himself. And he is telling that I am badly engaged in householder affairs. And Dina Chetasam. And that is why I am Dini. He is not telling for himself, but for us, as we are always engaged in this. We forget Krishna, we forget Guru, Vaishnava and all others, and engage always in this. Anyhow, you are somewhat fortunate that you are in good association. Now something realizing. But there are some weaknesses also. Try to drive all these things. So, it has been quoted though, but has it been quoted for Mahaprabhu or not? Though Raya Ramananda told it, this is slow. Mahaprabhu is Mahapurush or what? He is not Mahapurush only. He is Maha Maha Mahaprabhu. He is Swami Avatari, himself, Krishna. More than Krishna even combined, Radha and Krishna. So, also a slok, parallel slok has been told by Maharaj Yudhisthira. Bhavaddidha Bhagavata, Tirthi Bhuta Swayam Prabho, Tirthi Kurvant Tirthani Swantasthain Gadabhrita. Bhavaddidha. Yudhisthira Maharaj is telling to Bidhu. Some time before, Mahabharata battle was fought, he left everything, his position, his prime ministry and everything, because his brother Dhritarashtra was blind by internally and externally. He was grihinam dina chetasam, really he was. He tried so much that he should give up Duryodhan. Reject. And he should call Pandavas and give proper respect to them. But Duryodhan at once came. Oh, you are taking prasadam in what plate and you are hole in this patta. And then at once he gave up his crown, his everything, ministry, and he left that. And when battle was fought, all were put to death, all Duryodhan and all his brothers, only 5 Pandavas, Krishna one side and other side Aswasthama, Kripachar, Ketvar. But really, no one in that side. Then he came. He knew also that Krishna has left this world. All his Jadubansi has come. But he did not told all these things. And then Yudhishthira Maharaj telling at that time, Bhat Pidha, oh Vaishnu like you. Bhagavata, Bhagavata, you are Bhagavata. Tirthi Bhuta Swayam Prabho, you are himself Tirth of Tirth, because you have kept Gadadhar in your heart. Gadadhar means? Plow. No. Who has taken Bansi float on his at that very Gadadhar. So wherever you will go and take bath, it will be Tirtha. Now it is Tirths are very. Oh, all sinner person are taking bath. How should we be more again like that? And Krishna sends persons like you, O Vidur. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, Krishna, we can take him like that. He was also Mahabhagavat because he has played the role of Mahabhagavat. Then, something more. Oh, now something, Kirtan. One Kirtan. What I told. And then Mahaprabhu went to a Brahmin house and Ramananda Rai, he went, returned back to his palace. Mahaprabhu told that I will wait for you in the evening, so please come and we will do Harikatha. So Mahaprabhu was waiting him very eagerly. Mahaprabhu himself waiting. And Raya Ramanand what? He was also. So only in a very simple dress, with only one servant, he came there. Anyhow, in high way. in secret way he came. Mahaprabhu was waiting, and when he saw, Raraman did namaskar, and he wanted to fall on his feet, but at once he embraced him. And thus, both were asvastic because of him. After that, when they sat, they began to do conversation with each other. Harikatha, question and answer. Vaishnava, when meet, how are you? No question. They know all these things. Nothing. They will, how your bhajan is going on? And we should try to, how your bhajan? Now he is telling Mahaprabhu, Prabhu kahe, padaslok sadhya nirnaya. And Raya kahe, swadharma acharane Vishnu bhakti hai. Raramananda, padaslok, why he is telling that you should read his slok? You should have a sadhya. What is sadhya? What is sadhya? Or he is telling that I want to know what you are telling, it should be according to Shastra. Upanishad, Vai, Upanishad, Quran, especially Srimad Bhagavata. I want to. You should give reference of Shastra. Without Shastra, I will not admit. And then Raraman told, Swadharma Acharane Vishnu Bhakti. What is Sadhya? We should all know. Without Sadhya, aim of the, aim and object of the life, they should. Otherwise, we are like animal. So we should know. And then, knowing after that, we should practice to have that. What is sadhya? You, Aranya Maharaj. Explain. In brief. Yes, sadhya. What is called sadhya? Try to listen very carefully. You should turn more.
Umagana timarandhasa Ganandana salakaya Chakshurunvalitam jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama. So, Srila Gurudev ordered me to discuss briefly the concept of sadhya. The word sadhya indicates the goal of life. What is the aim and object of your life? That is called your sadhya. And the method that you take up to attain that particular objective in your life, that is called sadhan. So sadhan means the process to attain sadhya, the goal of life. So later we'll hear how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, sadhya vastu sadhan bina keho nahi pai kripa kahe rai. Pabara upai. Alright, Ramananda, we have discussed sadhya, the goal of life. Can you tell me about the sadhya and the method to attain it? Why? Because no goal of life can be attained without taking up the appropriate sadhana. So we can give some examples. If the goal of your life is to become very wealthy, to earn lots of money, then you may think, what kind of sadhan you have to do to attain that? You may think, oh, by being a lawyer, then you can make so much money. So then you have to think, how can I become a lawyer? I have to go to the law college. If you want to become a farmer, then no need to go to law college, you should go to agricultural college. So depending on what type of goal you have in your life, then after fixing sadhya, the goal, after that you can understand what is the process to attain that goal. So for those who are sadhak, practicing devotees in this world, their sadhya is what? Bhava bhakti. In the heart of every living entity is an eternal loving relationship with Krishna. How it should be manifest, how to realize this sadhya, that is the process of pure bhakti. Kriti sadhya bhavet sadhya bhavasa sadhana vidha nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakatyam ridhi sadhyata. When we are engaged in hearing, chanting, remembering, for the specific purpose of manifesting a particular mood in the heart, then our hearing and chanting and remembering can be called sadhan bhakti. Otherwise, though we may be hearing, chanting and remembering, it is called sadhan abhas, a semblance of real practice. So if we want our hearing and chanting and remembering to be real sadhana bhakti, first the sadhya, the goal that you are aiming for, will have to be fixed. So if we say that the sadhya is bhava bhakti, this is not enough. Why? Because there are many different types of bhav, many different foundational emotions by which the living entity is related to Krishna. It may be in santaras, dasya, sakya, vatsalya or madhurya. And therefore, if we want to know what is sadhya of our life and discover the sadhan to attain it, we have to go to sadhu. So sadhu is that person. Sadno ti sadayati Krishna prema iti sadhu. The sadhu is the person who teaches you about sadhya, the goal of life, and he adjusts your practice so that you'll be doing pure sadhan to attain that. The person who does this is called sadhu, and when we experience this in our life, really this is called sadhu sangha. So here in this example, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was waiting eagerly to meet with Ramananda, right? Why? For sadhu sangha. So from him, he can hear about sadhya, the goal of life, specifically the highest goal of life, in this case, for him, the mood of Radharani. And for the living entities, the beauty of the mood of Radharani. He wanted to hear this from Ramananda Rai, and afterwards he will ask him, now I know the goal, please explain to me what is the method to achieve. So in brief, this is the idea of sadhya and sadhan.
Something more, if you want, can you tell? What? Yeah, nothing. Shyamrani can? Some more? No. Bhakti Shah?
How can I improve?
We all want happiness. Anyone who wants to be suffering, anyone's suffering? You want suffering? Oh, you should come, I will make you suicide. Why not? This is suffering. So anyone does not want. And that is why in Veda it has been told. Sarve sukhina. We want to be happy. But what we think from this material mind is really not happiness. In wealth, in position, in family life, out of family life, real happiness is not what we think. What is really happiness? Krishna is love. God is love. Love is God. And Krishna what? Ananda Swarupa. Sachida Ananda Swarup. Or Ananda Swarup. Anandam, I am Brahma. Anandam, mayam, mayo abhyasa. Not only Ananda, he is Ananda himself, but also Anandamaya. And we are part and parcels of Krishna. You don't know? Ananda means happiness. Quality is Ananda. And Ananda Maya, where plenty of Ananda, he is enjoying plenty of Ananda and giving plenty of Ananda. He is called Ananda Maya. Maya Prachur Arthi. Krishna is Ananda himself. Ananda Maya. That is why Vyasadeva told Ananda Mayo Abhyasar. Shankaracharya told her, oh, how it can be? Impossible. He is Ananda only, not Ananda Maya. So perhaps he was somewhat mad or
confused.
No, he has written any word like that. I don't remember. Oh, Bhrant. So Vyas is Bhranta in his Brahma Sutra. Why he wrote Ananda? He could not reconcile. No? But Krishna is both Ananda and Anandamaya. So, if you want to be happy, you will have to Anandamaya Abhyasa. You will have to remember, chant, hearing the sweet pastimes of Krishna, then really you can be happy. Otherwise you cannot be happy. But what conditions all things? Nityartha dena, bittena, durlabhena, atmatyuna, grihi, grihapatya, kap. We want that we should anyhow collect money, wealth. Without we cannot survive us. Oh, this is wrong. Nityarthi dena. If there is no money or wealth, you are worried for that. If too much money comes, then dacoits and others will shoot you and take you. I know a person, who was householder, a very beautiful wife, children. And to love them, he wrote his in will or any document that it belongs to my wife, out of love and affection. And he went to India, and in the meantime, that lady involved to others and took his all house, all property, or children and everything. And she, he began to weep, what to do. Again he married to other lady. And for love and affection, and that first wife should not take his all money, he wrote everything to second wife. And also to conceal taxes from government, to cheat. He wrote everything, what his everything was, property, house and everything by her wife. And he went to service, also doing service. And then in the meantime, that lady also was engaged in other husband and took all the wealth, everything, house, property. But still, they don't give up that. I told him to come with me and be with me. But he is not happy. He will again do service, and again he will marry any lady, and again. They will not come in this line. And they will not remember totally Krishna, who is Anandamaya. If you are chanting Krishna really with heart, Ananda will come. Surely, it has been told, Bhakti Vasudeve Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojita Janate Asu Vairagyam Gyanam Chada Ahetukam. Everything will come. Tattva Gyan will come, surely. And also detachment from body. I'm worried that why you are chanting names and why detachment is not coming. Why? O Prabhu, from his morning of his life, he did the Sangha of Pujya Parsitar Maharaj. Swami Maharaj, always chanting. But even he is not going to be a sannyasi. Why? Do you want to marry again? Not question to you, but all. But all. We are mad now. I have only not come to discuss all these, also these things to remind you. You cannot be happy. Nityarti dena bittena durlabhena atma mrituna. This is the cause of death. What is meaning of death? Or falling down from divine love and Krishna consciousness. If you have too much wealth, then any dacoit will come and in India very soon he will shoot you. Only for 5 anna paisa they will shoot. So many sadhus doing bhajan here and there in forest, and they keeping some donation which is coming in their own and told quills. And dacoit comes, have you anything? Oh, I have nothing. And they search and found them. So many. So, in the end, and collecting by wealth, your wife, children's, apatya, house, property, dogs, animals, your gardens, everything. They will not give you happiness. Only chanting and remembering of Krishna, meditating of Krishna. Only this happiness is prayojan. This is the life of God. So, how to achieve that goal? Happiness? Happiness means Krishna himself. His happiness and anandamaya both. Only this is the process. And process of bhakti of Rupa Goswami. Anna abhilashita sunyam jnana karmanya anabhikam anukullena krishna anusilena bhaktirikam. This will give you certainly happiness. Nityananda Prabhu taking his hand high and promising chathestangre bhrata kuru hari hari dhvan tamarisa ततो वा संसारांबुधि तरण दाव मई लगे सोटाई रटे रत्यान प्रतिगृहम भजे नित्यानंदम भजे. You should chant and remember Krishna. I am responsible that. If you are not happy, well, I am responsible. So I am telling also you all that you should chant and remember, giving all your worry and everything. And chant and remember Krishna, you must be happy. Otherwise, I am responsible for this. Swamiji also came for this. And he told, those who obeyed him, they are happy, they will be happy. And those who will not, they did not follow him, they fall down from the line, and now even they are in life, they are taking wines, smoking, meat and all these things, and they have been doing.